Marco.
We're chasing the bait up. Jump in the boat, bro. Keep your eye on him. There's something about stray lining, eh? Just that anticipation, that run, and the way strike. Has he got it?
And then it's just the sound, you know?
Yeah.
Like that.
You mean that sound? Yeah!
This week, we're heading out from Whangaroa Harbour, where we plan to catch some bait and head out to make the most of the early morning bite time. But when fishing in salt water, your plans can change in an instant.
Yeah, gotcha, Blair, go ahead.
Captain Phil was showing us his best livey spot and we've found something else a bit bigger.
Oh, something come and eat one of his liveys?
Yeah, it's either a shark or quite a big king.
We'll come check it out. See you in a sec.
Things that happen when you're bait fishing.
Has it been on any big long runs?
Yeah,
so maybe a kingy.
Yeah, it just keeps on going.
I think I was telling you the other day, old some guys were over Totra North and they got 5 in the harbour, straight out. Oh, hang on, better not say where those big kingies were on camera. It's in fact not all that uncommon. When you're catching your bait fish, of course, it's just like live baiting. So the old kingfish comes along and you can get them hooked up. But the trouble is it's just such thin line, little wee tiny hooks, and the odds of actually landing one are very slim. But Phil's had this one on for over half an hour now, and he's just at the stage where he's putting that little bit of extra weight on. So it's could all come to an end one way or another very soon. Well, our kingy fishing this morning has become a spectator sport. So, do you want a cuppa, Mandy?
Oh, okay.
There you go, nice cuppa, middle of winter.
I'm being a bit greedy chewing into the day like this. I feel rather bad. I'm having fun, so I don't care.
At least we're getting a nice Whangaroa harbour tour this morning, a guided tour from a kingfish.
He knows exactly where he's headed. I think he's just going to take me straight into the bricks.
We'll go in there with the boat, go on the other side of the woolly, and we'll see if we can scare the fish out so it stays away from the rocks. It's only a thin line. If it comes in here, it's going to rub them off. So we're just doing our best to try and scare the kingfish back out into deeper water.
I'm gaining on him, so that's good. There it is.
Oh, I've seen it.
It's a king.
It's a kingy. That's a kingy.
He's hooked in the side, I think. That's the problem. He's hooked in the side. What a scrapper.
Oh, what an effort. Oh, well done. Fell hook kingfish.
On a sabiki.
Look at that, baby.
In the harbour, fishing for live bait. Yahoo, thanks for playing, buddy. Sweet.
Ow. Right, now let's go fishing.
Sorry about that, guys.
That's all right.
We've now missed the early morning bite time for snapper in the shallows. So we decide to go deep for the afternoon, and then we'll come back into the shallows and target snapper on dusk and fish into the night.
These are our marks. If I can get this drift right. Rightio, I've just rigged up a live bait and a dead bait there for Wooly. So knowing that there's snapper, kingfish and harpooker here, that rig will catch all three of the above. So drop that down. And of course Mandy's pounced on my jig set there.
Yeah.
Which she's got going pretty good. The technique is down. We're looking sharp, team. I'm really impressed. Bait's peeking out. But we let it go, I think. Hopefully that might get him mad, get him to come back. Yeah, oh, he's bit. Yeah, oh, he is bit. What am I on? Drive the boat at the same time makes it a little bit tricky. Yeah, it's only small, whatever it is. Hasn't taken any line. Little kingfish. Took that great big live bait too. Ha, look at that, the live bait's still there. That's probably a good illustration of just how big a bait that a kingfish will take on. A kingfish can eat another fish up to 1/3 of its body length. And that mackerel there is probably about a quarter of its body length. There you go. The bait, the rig, everything's right, except the kingfish is just too small. I'm gonna go home so we can fatten up some of those other big mamas that are here. There you go. There he goes.
Marco.
We're chasing the bait up. Jump in the boat, bro. Keep your eye on him. There's something about stray lining, eh? Just that anticipation, that run, and always strike. Has he got it?
And then it's just the sound, you know?
Yeah.
All like that.
You mean that sound? Oh, you got him on, Wooly?
Not very big.
Be a snapper, probably. Yeah. We've got a snapper. There we go. Snapper on a livey. Oh, there you go. That's a nice eater. Well, this time on our lure cam, I'm putting a bait into the water. So rather than lure cam, it has become bait cam, and we're going to drop that down and just see what's going on down there. Get ready, Mandy. There's some kingy marks here.
Yeah, you're in.
Rod tip up. Oh, you lost it, did you? Yeah. Like when you hook up, just keep winding. You can even keep your jigging action going with it hooked up for a while, okay. Because it's like you're uppercutting him, just keeping his head up and just nudge all the way up. Rod tip up, keep winding. I want to see that rod bent. That's a girl. Is that near the bottom or what?
Yeah, that was right on the bottom.
Might be another snapper, or maybe not. Tighten up if you have to, you don't let it rub you off. But it's starting to, there you go. Look at that. Live bait getting eaten. Oh, yep, there was a bite. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Go, girl.
Ah, nice one. See, you're dominating them now. You're dominating them now, man. Well done. Yes, a nice one. Just walk back so I can get the leader. Yeah, there you go. Okay, now, we're not going to muck around with this one.
Okay.
Mainly because I want to get my lure cam back down. Beautiful fish. Say bye-bye.
See you, matey.
Rightio, and you're away again. Jigging.
Wow! I'm going to have some burning muscles tomorrow morning.
Oh, Wooly, go the sunset boat, go over the button. Stop him, move him, because he'll get to ground, mate. Move him, keep him moving.
Gone.
No, keep him moving, mate. You've got to get him moving. If there's a stalemate, you'll lose, see? Rub you off, did he? Bugger. That was a donkey, mate. That was the one. That was our 30 kilo plus number.
Next time.
Jump on, Blair.
Marco.
We're chasing the bait up.
I bet he's after that camera.
Jump in the boat, bro. Keep your eye on him. This time of year, we've been cold. The Marcos are likely to be bigger.
It's clear.
You can see it?
Yeah.
It's clear now, is it? Sweet. Woohoo! Yep. And that's been smoked off. Alright, now let's just check that. Oh yeah, it was rolling. Oh, that footage is going to be awesome, but as much as I love getting the footage, I've actually got to have a fish now. Lure cam's going away, but it was worth it, wasn't it? Okay, flick those lights on, Mans. Wow, end of daytime and start of nighttime, and we're switching over into night fishing mode. We just got a nice bit of current flowing back through here onto a little bit of foul. We're going to get some burley going, and maybe an evening or nighttime snapper session. Oh, go, man. Keep it moving. Oh, Wooly's got been picked up as well. And I'm still rigging up! Good work, man. He's leading the charge. We'll be taking that puppy home. Don't you worry about that.
Oh, hello.
Go, Wooly. You got him, mate. Oh, go, Wooly. Go, Wooly. Oh, that's a nice snapper, boy. That's that salmon burley, mate. It just works.
Yeah, it's a nice
well
one.
Well done. Just good eaters, man.
Awesome. Go back if he wants. He's just hot. Look, you want them?
Oh, no, he's a good sized eater. I think we'll keep him, will he? Yeah. I want to take home a feed, mate, so.
Sort of eating snapper.
There's something about stray lining, eh? Just that anticipation, that run, and do I strike? Has he got it?
Oof. And then it's just the sound, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, like that.
You mean that sound? Yeah. Did it stick?
No.
Oh, no. With my overhead reel, I don't get that sound. And it's probably a good point. If you're going to be using spinning tackle when doing this sort of stray lining, it must have a bait runner system. And the Shimano bait runners, I was going to say they don't get much better, but the Shimano Tunnus, like these guys are using, is one step better. Pumping out the cubes. Just keeping that trail constant, you know, little wee chunks just like that. A little crumb trail, like a little Hansel and Gretel, or something like that. Oh, a whole big fresh mackerel that we caught this morning. Oh, down to a billy trail in the dark. Oh, the anticipation is awesome.
Here we go again.
Mandy and me at the same time, and that's in. Oh yeah, not a big one this time though. Just a nice snap. Got the feel of it. Oh, hang on, this is taking line. There's a nice wee running. I love it. I just love this so much. Oh, you can barely hear that line going out when it's running, eh? It's just so smooth. This fish will be pretty close now. There he is, I can see him. He's glinting there in the light. Nice snapper. I think this one might have to make the trip home with us as well. It falls into that range of fish that we like, size that we like to eat. Well, actually, I decided I think I might let him go. And second thoughts. Oh, there we go. Willie will make up for it. Go on in, get in there. Oh yeah. Well, take that one, I think, will you?
You doing?
Yeah. You'll take some home to eat, will you?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, well, there you go. Now we're going to make sure we bloody feed the backs. And just once it's over the side, poke a couple of holes in it, mate. You don't need many, eh? It just comes out pretty good. Oh. Oh, on me or Mandy, who do we go to? Mandy's hooked up. Mandy's hooked up, I've got a fish running on mine.
You got it?
Yeah. Go underground, yeah, that's right. What the good ones do. So try and pump them out. Just hold the spool a wee bit so it doesn't run yet and give them a few pumps. See if you can move them. Breaky, you've got them out, see? Good work.
Yeah,
there
awesome.
You go. You don't want to let them get in too deep. Stop the line coming out, give them some pumps. And you can quite often pump them out. Like, get in there. That was good stuff. Something's got that, you can see it running out. I've only got the hook just through the nose, so I'm really letting him eat it. And he's got him. I love it. There, panty. Panty. Yeah, just hooked. Just enough though. He's going home. Like with this, because I've taken it in half, you can treat it pretty much like a pilchard. Go through once, through twice from the same side, so you're wrapping it back around.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yep. And then half hitch around the tail. And of course, he's gonna come in for that gutsy bit. Whammo. Just give him plenty of time. And your bait runner, make sure it's wound down to the minimum amount of tension too. There is a tension adjuster.
Yeah.
Make sure that's as light as possible so he can really suck it in.
Alright, okay, cool. Nice, new, fresh, half butterfly.
Oh yeah, that's the one, man.
No.
That was a nicey. That was a nicey.
It smoked. It actually smoked.
Burley keeps fish biting. Time to freshen it up. Look at all the oil in there. There's just pure minced up king salmon. And it works. It works good. Keep fish biting for longer. Oh, hello. Is that your livey, Mandy?
Yeah.
Let it eat it.
Yeah, you tell me when.
Okay, give it to it. Wind.
Wind now,
and lift. That's yes, it. You got it.
Oh, you got it.
Oh, no, that was pulling line. That was a nice one, man. The old night line.
Bad so luck. Close.
Oh, it's come back. Is it an icy? Well, not the same caliber as the last one, but it's all right.
Feels all right.
Oh, yeah, it's a nice one. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh, yeah.
Customer.
Slightly. Yep, colours, aren't they?
It's the anticipation.
Oh. Here goes Mandy. She's tight. Stock standard one.
Oh, you don't tire of it though. You don't tire of those.
But I can go back, I think.
Man, they can pull.
Okay, Wooly. We might have to come back to this. Listen. No, as we were. So, you know, we've had no bike catch, eh? It's just been snapper. That's how we roll. Ahoy. Oh, I let it go. I just tossed out a livey into the darkness. Something's got it. Oh, hello. Oh, yep. Live bait. Oh, it's taking line. It's not a monster. That's amazing. Look at that, he's still got the live bait. So just goes to show you, even in the dark, these snapper are predating. You can see that lit up blue colour on them too. We've spoken about that in the past, when snapper light up blue like that, just like a whole lot of other fish do, marlin, tuna, swordfish light up blue in order to confuse their prey. And that is a nice snapper at night, you beauty. I think I'm going to let that one go because he's only hooked in the corner of the mouth. Away you go, buddy. Oh, away he goes. Nice. Is that a live bait too, Wooly?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that'll be a nice one then if it's on the livey. Go, Wooly. Go, Wooly. You got 30-pound line so you can give him heaps. Oh yeah, go on, they got heaps of drag, you got heavy line, mate, just hold on to them. Oh, that's another nice one, another nicey, just slide them on over, mate. Oh, got me in the, oh. That's a nice one, mate, that's a nice one, well done, Wooly.
Yeah. Nice little fish.
Nice little fish. Oh, my livey has been smoked. Here we go. It's my livey. Uh-oh. Oh, you're much bigger fish. Will everything hold together now, though? This lighter line, as this fish will be looking for somewhere to rub me off. Saucer! The old night live baiting, eh? I just got some little colour out there, I think. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's just taking a bit of line still. Beautiful. Take your time, mate. Tell me when you've got him. You got him. Oh yeah.
Look at that.
Plonk him right there on the side of the boat, mate. That's a nice solid snapper, isn't he? This could have been some of those ones that were picking us up and running us off with us earlier on. The hook's in the corner of his mouth. VMC hook. They are just my favourite for these bigger snapper. They obviously still prey on other fish in the dark. So it just goes to tell you what their senses are like. Beautiful. And he's going home. Back into the darkness. To stooge around. Away he goes. Away he goes. Oh, yes! Mate, For our Hunting and Fishing New Zealand tackle tip this week, just a little hint for when you're fishing in the dark or low light conditions, a Lumo bead. And that's just that little plastic bead that I've got threaded on against my hook there. And I'm just going to show you how I rig it when I'm rigging my baits. I've got a VMC 9-barrow hook here. I'm just rolling that into place. But just before I do my half hitch around the tail, I slide the bead down onto the body of the bait, and then I do a half hitch over the tail. Now, that might look like an eye or something that's gonna be spotted by the fish in the darkness, but it's gonna draw it straight to the bait. Now, if it's on the bait, it's gonna come in. Once it gets within range, it's gonna see it, it's gonna bite it, it's gonna eat it. So there you go, Lumo beads. You sell them, don't you, Wooly?
Yeah, we do.
Well, there you go, available at your Hunting and Fishing New Zealand store, along with the rods and the reels and everything else. A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app. So wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.